Rhonda Sciortino, and I want to share with you the five things I wish somebody had told me before I started my organization. Number one, everyone who is with you is not for you. I had who I thought was an amazing right-hand person. She was dedicated, committed, hardworking, seemed to be just as concerned about the success of our organization as I was. But no, that wasn't exactly true. One day, I left for a business trip, and about the time I was probably arriving at the airport, she was packing up client files, prospect files, a lot of other confidential information, and carrying it out to her car. She was the VP of the organization, she was my right-hand person, so the other employees just watched her do it and didn't really question her. Thought it was a little odd, but some of them, turns out later on, told me that they thought she was a little odd. And so that was the day that she left and started her own company to compete with me. As if that wasn't bad enough, when I got where I was going and tried to check into the hotel, I'm rooting through my wallet and I realized that my American Express card was gone. She had literally stolen the American Express card out of my wallet and charged up the furnishings for her new office and a new wardrobe. So yeah, everyone who is with you is maybe not guaranteed to be for you. Number two, many people will care about the mission and vision of the company, but no one is ever gonna care as much as you do. I mean, I hope you find the person who does. I really didn't. I had a lot of people who were very, very close, and I'm so grateful for them. And I'm not trying to throw them under the bus. The point of me telling you this, number two point, is don't burn people out. I did. I thought everybody cared as much as I did, and everybody was willing to go the extra mile. And I always said, I don't expect anybody to do anything that I wouldn't be willing to do. I was willing to work 60 to 80 hours a week. I expected people to do what I did because I thought that they cared as much as I cared. And they cared a lot, don't get me wrong, many of them did. But I think a lot of people burned out and fell away along the way. I wish I hadn't done that. Number three, the power of agreement cannot be understated. Now, what do I mean by that? I argued a lot with the people around me. I wanted things to be absolutely right. I wanted them to be perfect. And okay was not good enough. Good was not good enough. It needed to be great. So I was constantly finding fault. I was constantly seeking perfection and arguing with people instead of building them up, instead of helping them to grow and grow into the position. I wish that somebody had told me that it would be good to just start by finding common ground with people and recognizing their efforts. Number four, find people's genius and then let them use it. Don't micromanage. I just needed to have my fingers in every single detail of every single thing. Not good. Number five, reward what matters, not what doesn't. I finally did learn this. I wish I had known this at the beginning. I implemented a bottom line performance bonus strategy that was equally divided among every employee. Yep, I said every single staff member. The receptionist got the same equal portion as my number two person and every other person who worked full-time in the company. You might think that doesn't sound fair. Everybody earned their level of salary according to their expertise and all of those things. But the whole organization doesn't work unless everybody is rowing in the same direction. So overall performance mattered. I rewarded, instead of just the superstars, I wanted to reward everyone. The quiet people, the people who usually don't get credit for anything, the people who show up and do their job without constantly needing to be recognized. And some people don't want to be recognized, but this performance bonus equally divided, I wish I'd known that from day one. So those are my five things. I hope they help you to grow your organization. If you haven't started one yet, follow your dream, follow your passion, and use everything that you're learning in these articles and these videos to create an amazing success for your life and the lives of everybody within your influence.